the six strongholds. Welcome to the 21 Days of Breakthrough for North Korea. This is a time when we are coming together as an international body of Jesus Christ to ask, seek, and find on behalf of North Korea. Ask for breakthrough, seek anointing, and find Jesus. Over the next 21 days, there will be daily downloadable video prayer points to pray through to strategically address six of the major spiritual strongholds in North Korea. We will be spending 3 days on each prayer point. These prayer points are the fruit of an intercession trip into North Korea, where God really opened our eyes to see the spiritual battle that was raging in NK and told us strategies that He was calling the church to step in order to enter this land and redeem its people. I had sensed before we went to North Korea that NK, along with the Middle East, were physical places on this earth where Satan had strongholds in the world, the places where he dwelt and had set up a type of commanding post. There was a time when I was praying for NK and Ephesians 6:12 came to mind. We do not battle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and every thought that is raised up against the knowledge of God. As I was praying, I saw in my mind's eye the topography of Pyongyang, and then another dark, shadowy city's skyline, above it, beyond it, and in it. I thought at once that this was the stronghold, the principality, or the city of darkness that was influencing NK society and holding it captive. It was such an alarming wake-up call that this battle certainly was not against flesh and blood. Since coming home, I believe that God has revealed to us six of the major strongholds that the enemy has been using to control North Korea. These are unforgiveness, pride, secularism, idolatry, fear, and division. They seem to have been Satan's welcome mat into the country, and he seems to have built them up to be much more than a welcome mat, but his strength. I'd asked the Lord, "What can we do, Lord? What are the ways to battle in the spirit?" I believe that the Lord has revealed His plan, that the church, we, need to do so much more than merely pray against these strongholds. I believe that He is calling us, the church, to go into North Korea, to go into prayer with the opposite spirit of these strongholds, that we need to live in a way and walk in a way that is in direct opposition to what the enemy is having the people of NK walk in, that we must walk in reconciliation, humility, faith, worship, trust, and oneness. This prayer thrust is not just a time when we can comfortably sit back and pray for North Korea at a distance. I believe that God is asking us, "Are you serious? Are you really asking for breakthrough? Then I need you to consecrate yourselves to the task at hand, to walk in these ways, to walk in a way that is worthy of the gospel of Christ." For the first 2 days, let us consecrate ourselves before the Lord. Let us confess any unconfessed sins of unforgiveness. Let us confess our sin of pride and self-dependence. Let us confess our sin of living as if this physical world was all that existed. Let us confess any idols in our lives, things that we are holding on to, that is hindering what God wants to do in our lives. Let us confess jealousies and divisions and fear, and let's receive as the body of Jesus Christ. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.